All right, I've had some requests to do some interior stuff. So what I'm going to do is apply the stuff we've already learned for exteriors, the modeling and all that kind of, all those kind of things, the materials, and just show you how to apply it to an interior. It's a little different for interior. The unique part that's especially for interior is the lighting. That's going to be a little different. So what I've done is I've set up a basic box here just out of polygons. And I've put a camera inside. I'm using Vray again, and a Vray physical camera. And I've got these windows on the side. So this is just a very basic room. I'll show you how to do a basic lighting setup for an interior scene like this. First thing you have to consider is kind of, well, first of all, let's put a generic material on this. So we can light it with just an all gray material. And we'll figure out the lighting before we really put any colors into the scene. And that's one way to do it. It's not the only way to do it. You don't have to do it that way. But for the sake of time, I'm going to do it this way and not spend all the time to put colors and materials everywhere, because this is just for demonstration purposes. So make sure you take your physical camera and you set your vertical tilt to be correct. Mine's not cooperating for me. It is set properly, but it's not displaying. That's okay. But we need to make sure that the vertical lines are straight up and down, like I showed you in the exterior series. This polygon here I've detached. I'm going to make one material for that, and it's going to be a glass. And we'll make it similar to the way we've made other glass. Set it to solid black. I'm going to be going through this pretty quick because we've gone over a lot of this before. You can see I have updated my version of V-Ray, but basically everything's the same. It's just moved a little bit around. So for now, reflections, we'll leave on for that glass. Turn up the reflection a little higher. For refract, what we're going to do here is make it pretty refractive. And because this is a single plane, we're going to kind of take off all the index of refraction. Just set it to 1.01. Kind of the magic number. So nothing's really distorting as it goes through that glass. Because it's a single plane, the distortion doesn't work like it really would. If this was a double plane, if I put a shell on that polygon, which I can do, let's do it that way. It's a nicer way to do it. But just keep this in mind. If you put a shell on it of, let's say, 0.5 inches, then you would just leave that refraction on. 1.6 will work. Leave that index or refraction number. Now, the important thing here is going to be effect shadows. That makes it so the direct light can come straight through that window. So let's apply this to the polygon. Call it glass. Okay, so now we have a basic gray material on everything, and then this glass. So I'll show you how to get the direct light coming through there. Remember, effect shadows needs to be on for that direct light to go through that glass. Let's do one other thing here. Let's move this glass into the mullions a little bit, like that. That's great. Okay, V-Ray Sun. Go to the Lighting tab. Drop down to V-Ray. Go to V-Ray Sun. And just click where you want the sun to be and drag where you want it to point. Would you like to automatically add a V-Ray Sky Environment map? Yes. Let's go to the right view and raise that sun up a little bit. So that'll be coming in at that angle there. Now, one thing you need to keep in mind when doing this is that the V-Ray camera and the V-Ray sun is all set up for physical accuracy. So the sun is set to be as bright as the real world sun. So in other words, it's very, very bright. So in order to get the right exposure, you'd have to turn on exposure in your camera and turn your shutter speed up, like with a real camera, so that it doesn't get too bright. But what I like to do, and this is another way to do it, it's kind of a workaround, you can just set this to about 0.05, the intensity multiplier of the sun. Then you can just turn off the factor, the exposure factor, and turn off the vignetting as well. That way the sun is now dim enough that it's not totally blowing out your scene. And you're just using default exposure for the camera now. all that really does is take one more factor out of your lighting equation, because it's kind of a moving target if you're trying to adjust both of these at the same time and trying to get the exposure just right. So I just take one out of the equation and only adjust the sun now. That's one way to do it. You can also just leave the exposure on, set all your lights how you think they should be, and then just adjust your exposure up and down until it looks like the right exposure. So, we've got our sun. Let's do a basic rendering now. Okay, one other thing I should mention before I render. This is what it was coming out like, but obviously there's a big purple plane outside. I don't remember if I've showed you before, but that's a V-Ray plane. So, it's that. And if you go to Create, Object, V-Ray, V-Ray plane, you can create that, and it's just an infinite plane, basically. So I've set it, doesn't matter where you set it in your scene, in the X and Y axis, but in the Z axis, the Z world axis, it does matter. So I've set it just below the floor. The only thing I forgot to do is assign this gray material to it. And that plane extends infinitely outwards. So let's try rendering again. We're looking pretty good here. As you can see, effect shadows is working. The light's coming right through the windows. And of course, with the global illumination on, the light is hitting the floor, bouncing up through the room, and lighting the entire room. Super simple setup, but it gives you a very nice effect with a nice soft lighting in the whole room just from putting that direct light in. So if you wanted a scene where only direct light is coming in, you could put these big windows, fill up the whole room with it, and you're pretty much done lighting your interior scene. Now all you have to do is fill it with nice furniture. But I am going to show you a couple other things in case you want different lighting situations. So let's let this render. Okay, that's pretty clean right there. You can see the nice light, the nice crisp light coming through. And it gets a little fuzzier over here as it gets further away from the source of the shadow casting. Of course, you can always take your sun and you can increase the size of it, say like 6, and it'll increase the size of that disc. And what that does is make your shadows much softer, like maybe an overcast day, maybe. Let's exaggerate it a lot just to see what it'll do. Size multiplier. See what that looks like. Okay, now you can see that the shadows are much softer. They're not very clean because my settings are low, but you get the point. You get these very nice, big, soft shadows if you make that light source really big. Now that's something you need to keep in mind when you're lighting with V-Ray lights on the interior as well. Let me show you that. Actually, before I get to that, let's show you one other technique, which is to put a big V-Ray plane light. Again, V-Ray lights, create V-Ray, no, lighting tab, V-Ray light. Now there's a couple different kinds of lights here. Plane, dome, sphere, mesh, disc. Okay, we are going to use the plane. It's the one I use probably most commonly. And the names are self-explanatory, but mesh is any object that you want to make self-illuminated. Now, I made a V-Ray plane about the size of that window. It's a plain light. Let's place it just outside the window, and we're going to pump it through that glass to make it so that there's a nice diffuse light coming in from the windows, like they're a giant light source. You don't want to play this up too much. In fact, 2 might be the multiplier we want. And now remember, when you have a large light source like this, the intensity increases with the size. So a really big light like this set at 2 is actually a lot of light coming out. If it was a tiny little light set at 30, it would still be probably less than this. Okay? So the size matters as far as intensity. So if we set it at 2, and if you set it to like the color of the sky, it'll basically be pumping environment light into that room. This is a technique that people use a lot to light their scenes with a natural looking lighting. So let me render that for you. One important thing I forgot to tell you is to make that light invisible. Because as you can see, that the direct light was not coming through that light. It was hitting it, and you're actually seeing the solid light right there. So make sure it's invisible. You can actually turn off effect reflections, because you don't want to see that in like a mirror or something, because we want it to be hidden. But it can still affect the diffuse. That means it's lighting the room still. And the specular, that means it's putting highlights on objects in the room. So let's try that again. Okay, you don't really see it a lot because it's not overpowering this direct light very much at all. But it is a subtle light coming in. You can see it hitting the wall right there. There's a bluish tint up here where we put in that wall. You might want to turn that up. You might want to not have it at all because this room is small and that direct light is really filling up the room with light a lot. So you might not need it there. If you had a smaller window, you'd definitely want to pump some more light in using a V-Ray plane outside. So that is another technique. Now a little bit about your interior lights. There's basically really two different options, and that's all you need to know, essentially. There's the regular V-Ray light, and there's a plane. A dome is for environment light, so you wouldn't use that for an interior. A sphere is just a ball that puts light in all directions. A mesh is any object that you assign it to will become a light. And the disc light is like a, well, it's exactly what it says. It's a disc-shaped light. Okay, disc is a newer feature. In the newer versions of V-Ray, you may or may not have it. But because it's new, I haven't really worked it into my workflow yet. But I've always used just planes for lights on the ceiling. But really, disc will probably be what I use more in the future moving forward, because usually I'm putting can lights in the ceiling and they're shaped like discs, not planes. But let me show you how to do it with planes, and the same, basically all the same things will apply to a disc as well. So plane light, if you have like a 6-inch can up here, put your half width and your half length at about 3 inches. That's exactly what it says it is. That's half the width and half the length of that light. So if it's half is 3, then the full is 6. So that's about the size of a can light. Okay, make sure and put that up here. Now you'd actually model a can light too, and then you'd probably put this right in front of it so that the model of the can light is probably got a self-illuminated bulb on it, but that's not what's actually lighting your scene. You'd put a light in front of it to actually light the scene. That's the best way to do that. And then this would be somewhere around, sometimes these get high, like 100 maybe, and you'd put them with probably a warmer light because most light bulbs are warmer. In people's houses, you have somewhere like around in here, right? Something like that. That's like a soft white light bulb. Okay, and those will be invisible too because you don't want to see that plane sitting in front of your modeled can light. These can affect, well, no, you don't want those to affect reflections either. What that means is if you have a mirror or something in your room and you see the can light in your mirror, you'll see that light sitting in front of it. You don't want that, but it will still make highlights on objects in your room because the effect specular is on. Okay, now the other thing that you, subdivisions is kind of the quality of light coming off of it. You don't usually have to mess with the default. The other thing that you might want to mess with is the directional. So zero means that it's going straight out to the sides and down from this plane. Okay, so it's going like in an arc like that around the light. If you put directional to 1, that means it's coming only in the direction of the normal and that arrow coming off that light. So it's going straight down. And it maintains that profile all the way down to the ground. So you'll see a light. It's like a spotlight coming right down to the ground. You'll see a light in the shape of this plane being cast right onto the ground. So that's not what you want, but you might want, for a can light, they are directional somewhat, so you might set this to maybe 0.2 or 0.3. And let's move it over by the wall so we can see how it's cast, and I'll just do a quick render of it for you. Let's make sure it's in a good place in our room. Let's put it like over here. And render. Okay, here you can see that plane light casting light down the wall. You see it doesn't fan out too far because I did put some direction on it. Obviously, it's a little too close to the wall, but the intensity looks pretty good, I think. Let's change that real quickly to a disk. You'll see that it'll look basically the same. But let's make it a little more directional. 0.6, and I'll show you how it looks. Let's move it away from the wall a bit. And let's put a few more in here. So hold down Shift, instance it twice, and then we'll instance it three times across the room, like that. Now I've got a bunch of light in there, and these are all instanced, so if you turn down one, which because we've got so many in here now, we'll probably want to turn them down to 70. That'll turn down all of them. Let's turn this up a little bit. Let's turn our sun back to the regular size. Okay, and we'll see how that looks really quick. All right, well, there you have it. That's pretty much a basic setup for an interior lighting. You can see that the brightest spot, of course, is where the sun is hitting, as it should be. But you have a nice balance of artificial light in here, too. It's a little bit being cast on the walls. And over here, you can see there's a lot of light from those can lights we put in. There's very subtle light coming from these windows, from that big plane. So really, it's a nice, bright, kind of a little bit maybe overexposed. But once you start putting color in there, I think it's all going to look good. So if you want to know how to fill this up, go check out my 3ds Max furniture class, and you'll see how to model knickknacks, objects, and furniture to put inside this scene. That should be very helpful to you. And the only other thing I want to mention is that the other option here for lighting for these cans, you could also use a Vray IES light, which is right here. So we better go to the top view to put that in. Where is it at? We want. Okay, there you go. So that just looks like a sphere with a target on it, which is all fine. But if you don't know what IES lights are, then they're just a file that you can assign to this light, which is put out by the manufacturer of actual lights, and it gives you the exact pattern that that light will be cast in. So all you have to do is assign that file here. So if you search the internet for .IES files, you will find some, and usually they'll have a preview with them of how that light is going to cast. So you know each bulb casts in its own particular pattern, and that is provided by the manufacturers of lights, oftentimes with an IES file. So you can assign it here, and then you just kind of adjust it like you would any other light, with intensity, and here you adjust it with color and power down here. So the settings look a little different, but the idea is all the same. And that can give you a more accurate look to your lights and how they're casting on the wall. They're oftentimes not necessary, but if you really want to showcase a nice scallop on your wall of light, then you could use IES lights. And if you need to be particularly accurate for some reason, you can get the information from the manufacturer and plug it right into these lights. So that is the other option. The only other thing is like a sphere light. So if you had a big pendant light hanging down in the middle of this room, or a chandelier or something, you can just put a sphere light in the middle of the room like that. And all that is just like the plane, same settings as the plane, except it's casting in all directions. So that's basically all there is to V-Ray lights, and this is the very basics of how you would set up a V-Ray interior. So again, if you want to know how to finish something like this off with furniture materials, just check out my other courses, particularly the Furniture Masterclass, because that's all about making the high-poly objects that would go in a scene like this to really make it look sharp. So thanks for checking this one out. And we'll talk to you soon.